what's going on, guys? Today, I'm going to kind of show you a few more pickups that I got recently, within the last 2 days, actually. Not sure when this video is going up. Maybe on Friday, so you guys will know anyways. So it'll be 3 days since I got these cards, and since posting his collection video, I thought I'd show a few more of mine. So, as you guys have seen previously, I have an awesome Planeswalker collection that I am trying to grow. So, there's a bunch of them. None of these ones are really new. I got Narset, Venser the Sojourner, Sarkhan Unbroken, Deseret the Seeker, and Ob Nixilis of the Black Oath since last time, which I'm so excited about because Venser and Deseret are some of my favorites. Not sure if there's anything else that I got that's new in these pages. There might be some more towards the back. But it's still pretty sweet. Then I got two foils and one not foil ziggurat vanished long ago. When progenitus awakened, the temple emerged again. So, I want to put one of these for sure in my Yale deck. And one probably in like a sliver deck or a five-color deck of some sort. Then I got some random lands and ramp stuff. So I got another drowned catacomb. Enters tapped unless you control an island or swamp. And taps for each of those colors. Interland Harbor is the same, but with green and blue. In places where the sea meets the trees, it's easy to forget the darkness that rules most of Innistrad. Isolated Chapel is the same, but white and black. Not every church is a place of faith. Clifftop Retreat is the same, but with red and white, so Boros colors. Where Cathars learn to fight, not only demons and vampires, but ignorance as well. Temple of Deceit. Enters tapped, and you can scry one when it enters. And it taps for a blue and a black. Watery Grave. Enters tapped. You pay 2 life, and it's for blue or black. I fear that as we scurry after phantoms, the Demir pull 9 puppet strings. Cryptic Gateway is an artifact that costs 5. Tap 2 untapped creatures you control. You may put a creature card from your hand into play that shares a creature type with each creature tapped this way. So, really awesome and tribal stuff. If you play dragons or something, that's great. Its lock changes to fit each key. And I got a foil, Zendikar Resurgent. It's an enchantment for 7. Whenever you tap a land for mana, add 1 mana to your mana pool of any type that land produces. Whenever you cast a creature spell, draw a card. It's a really, really awesome card. A little expensive, but in green, that's nothing. So, those are the lands and the mana producers and stuff like that. Now on to the beef. The really good cards. So, the first one is a staple in any card that can play blue, any deck that can play blue. Phyrexian Metamorph. You can pay 3 and 2 life, or 3 and a blue. It's a 0/0. It's a shapeshifter. It can enter the battlefield as a copy of any artifact or creature on the battlefield, except it's an artifact in addition. So, copy any soul ring, sword, creature, anything. It also has an infinite combo with Shroom the Hegemon, which is why I bought it. A card that I've never owned, but I've always wanted to, is Mind Slaver. Costs 6, but you can pay 4 and tap it to control target player during that player's next turn. It's a helm that leaves the head at its most vulnerable. A really, really, really fun cube card. Mind Twist. X and a black. Target opponent must discard X cards at random from his or her hand. If they don't have enough cards, they discard their entire hand. And it's at random, so that makes it really good. Balance, one of the most unbalanced cards in Magic. It's a sorcery for 1 and a black, white. Whichever player has more lands in play must discard enough lands of his or her choice to equalize the number of lands both players have in play. Next, equalize the cards in hand and then creatures in play the same way. Creatures lost in this manner are considered buried. So, your lands, your cards in hand, and creatures in play all have to be whatever the lowest damage tick. So for that card, I need Doomsday. You pay 3 black, pay half your life rounded up, put your graveyard on top of your library, then remove all but 5 cards of your library from the game. Put the rest on top of your library in any order. So you basically pick 5 cards that win you the game in one turn. Awesome deck, but expensive, because I need to buy that card, and this card, ad nauseum, it's an instant for 5, reveal the top card of your library, then put that card into your hand, you lose life equal to its converted mana cost, you may repeat this any number of times, when the task spilled into undead, he stopped calling it his life's work. This card is a commander unto itself, and a really, really fun black card. Really cheap, like really douchey to play, but super fun. Skittles, Skithrix, the Blight Dragon. It's a legendary creature, dragon skeleton for 5. It's a 4/4 with flying and infect. Legendary Angel, 7/7 for 9. It has flying. When it enters the battlefield, choose a color. Your opponents can't cast spells of the chosen color. No more shall the righteous cower before evil. Shuts down monocolored decks so easily. And yeah, blocks out blue, which is amazing. Almost always cheated into play, whether it be reanimated or cheated out with like Mayel, Quicksilver Amulet, stuff like that. Whoops, the tripod. Omniscience. It's a 10 cost blue enchantment. You can play non-land cards from your hand without paying their mana cost. So you pay 10. That's all you play while this is on the field, or while you pay. The things I once imagined would be my greatest achievements were only the first steps towards a future I can only begin to fathom. Jay Spellerin. So this card, you also usually cheat into play with like show and tell and other stuff, and you just basically win from there. If you have Tamiyo out and you can ultimate her, it's as easy as that. Well, you should win with this, but if you have Tamiyo ultimated, you play everything you want. Your spells go back to your hand. You just repeat as many times as you want. This is a really good card, but because of EDH, where I play it, it is now a $25 card. Sarah Ascendant. It's a 1/1. You have 30 or more life, it gets 5/5 and flying. So if you open this card in your hand, turn 1, it's a 6/6 flying lifelink creature. GG, right there. Okay, these next 4 cards are the last ones I have, and they're all really amazing. Stoneforge Mystic. It's a 1/2 for 2. When it enters the battlefield, you may search your library for an equipment card, reveal it, put it into your hand, then shuffle your library. You pay 2 and tap it to put an equipment card from my hand onto the battlefield. So anything that costs a ridiculous amount just goes onto the battlefield. And if you have Nayiri in your deck or as the commander as well, Fleshnorn Grand Cenobite. It's a 4/7/7 with vigilance. Other creatures you control get +2/+2. Creatures your opponent controls gets -2/-2. The Cataxian Whisper. The Cataxians whisper among themselves of other worlds. If they exist, we must bring Phyrexia's magnificence to them. Really, really awesome card. I just like how it looks, too. Like, look at that. So awesome. Always reminds me of Pyramid Head from Silent Hill. The newest addition to my Planeswalker collection, Soren Markov. He is a 4 loyalty Planeswalker for 7. You can +2 him to deal 2 damage to target creature or player, and you gain 2 life. Or, what he's always used for, is -3. Target opponent's life total becomes 10. And -7, you control target player during their next turn. So, for -7, you have Mindslaver. But to knock any opponent down to -10, or to 10, is amazing. Sometimes you just have to. Life gain decks can get out of hand. And the final card that I purchased today is none other than the amazing demon, Gristlebrand. It is a 7/7/8. It's a legendary demon with flying, lifelink. You can pay 7 life to draw 7 cards. Avacyn emerged from the broken hell vault, but your freedom came at a price. Him. So guys, that is the collection of cards I got today, or I guess yesterday. There are some amazing staple cards in there that you just, if you're an EDH player,